Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. In this video about OneNote, we're going to be talking about tags. Let's face it, the reason most of us like to use notebooks, paper notebooks, is because of the special markings that we can do in it. The highlighting, the little boxes, the little stars, all that kind of stuff. But what you can do on paper, you can do in OneNote. So let me show you how. Let's say I have in my OneNote notebook a list of things that I want to make sure I accomplish this week. Rather than just typing out that list, I can put a OneNote tag in front of each of these items so then I can check off the box to say I'm done. So the first tag I'll share with you is that to-do tag, and that's the one you're going to see on the home ribbon of your OneNote toolbar. So if I go to the top of my home ribbon here, you'll see there's that little checkbox icon, and I can just click on that, and whatever line I'm on, it just happened to be on the last line of my list here, it puts a tag around it. I can click on anywhere on the line that I want and click on that tag. The tag always goes to the left of whatever line I'm on. There's a couple of tags that will highlight the line, but most tags go to the left of the item. So I'm going to just highlight the other two lines here and click on this, and you'll see that it put that tag on whatever I highlighted. Now, one more little tip with this tag is I can just go Control 1, so using my keyboard, that shortcut, and that will create a tag on whatever line I'm on. I've added a line in here that says remember Control 1, so I'm just gonna go Control 1, and it puts that to-do box in front of that line. Perfect. Now, let's move on to a few other tags that you can utilize within OneNote as well. So I'm on a new page here for my meeting notes. And let's say that I want to put the to-do tag on the second line here. We need to contact the vendor. So that's kind of a to-do. So now you'll see how these tags can work in conjunction with the notes that you're keeping. So the Control 1 put that there. But what other tags are there for us to discover? Let's click on the arrow beside that to-do tag and see the other choices that we have. And so you see that right underneath the to-do tag, I have a number of other choices. And if I scroll down the list, it's not necessarily a very long list. Now, depending on what version of OneNote you're using, you might have a longer list than I have, and that's totally fine. But just notice that at the very bottom of this list, I do have an option to create a new tag as well. So we'll do that example in this video very shortly. For now, let's use some of these other couple of tags. So I'm just gonna click on whenever we register new clients. Let's say that's a very important thing we want to remember. I'm gonna go to that tag and choose important. Now the next one is more of a question that I have in that sentence. So I'm gonna go to my tags and I'm gonna use the question tag. Then I have a remember this line here, so I want to remember whatever I've written in that sentence. So I can go to the drop down again, and I see there's a tag that says remember for later. This tag works a little bit differently. Just notice what happens when I click on it. It doesn't put a tag in front of the line, it just highlights the entire line that I'm on. And then I have another example here, a definition that I want to remember. We just so happen to have a definition tag, and it looks like a highlighter as well. So let's click on that. Different color highlight, which is totally fine. Okay, so you see how these things are going to help us with our notes. So as we enter our notes, you know, we can just add these tags in as we're typing if we want, or we can add these tags in later. And this is very much resembling that paper notebook that we would have handwritten in and we used a highlighter with, or use the question marks around stuff, or the boxes or stars around stuff. So this is, again, making it more relatable for us to how we used to take our notes on paper. Now, this last example I have, need to ask the boss if we can do something. So this one, I'm going to go to my tags and you're going to see I don't have a tag for that one in particular. So I want to create a new tag. So this is an example of a custom tag we can create. So I'll start by naming that tag. And so I can just say ask boss. And then I want to pick an icon for that tag. So it probably would be a good idea if I use a checkmark box, so that way when I've done it, I can check the box that I've asked them. And it's showing me that there's a number of featured icons I can pick from, or I can click on all icons, and that lets me see that there is a big long list of icons with more checkboxes. And the one that I want is the one that kind of has a little head in it. So let's just use the one with the green box. And it kind of shows me two icons, one without the check mark and one with the check mark. So I'm going to choose create. And I'm going to close out of there and use that tag now. So if I click anywhere on the line and I go to the drop down, then I go down here you see that it gives me that option for that. Now that checkbox looks a little bit different than my regular to-do checkbox. Once I've asked the boss that question, I can then go and check off that box, and that way I can keep track of what I've asked the boss and what I haven't. So what other tags can you create in OneNote? Maybe you want to create a custom tag that have to do with different things you do in your workday or different things you do with different projects. Maybe you have an idea tag you want to create. There's an idea for maybe posting on social media, or an idea you have for writing that next book. Maybe it's something you want to purchase later or remember to acquire later, and so that becomes a new tag for you. Whatever you can think of, you know, that is the tag that you want to create for yourself. This OneNote is for you. These tags are for you. You can create whatever tags make sense in your world and use them as you wish. Now, one more thing about the shortcuts. I showed you the shortcut of Control 1 with regards to the to-do tag. The reason Control 1 works is if I go to the drop down here, Control 1 is a to-do tag, but if I go in order of my tags here, Control 2 is important, Control 3 is question. So it's using the control and the number in order of my tags in my list. And so that means you only have 9 shortcut keys that you can use. So if you have more than 9 tags, you don't have any other shortcuts that you can pull from. Now, if you want to learn more about Microsoft OneNote, then why not take a look at the book that I've written, 324 pages of all kinds of tips and tricks on how to use this program more effectively. So this lesson today was taken from my book so I could give you a taste of what to expect. This book can be found on Amazon or any place you can purchase a book online from. So check it out. Thanks. Bye-bye.